from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Investigators are awaiting the results of an autopsy today to learn more about the death of 26-year-old Samantha Folsom.
Her body was found yesterday at her Oxford Street apartment. Public safety spokesman Steve McCausland says Folsom's parents found her body when they went to check on her after they had not heard from her recently. State and Lewiston police are both involved in this investigation. Officers have not said how Folsom died, but stay with News 8 and WMTW.com today as we learn more details in this case.
A Lewiston man is due in court today to enter a plea on a charge of murder.
Last month, Buddy Robinson was arrested for the death of Christiana Fesmeyer. She'd been missing since July, and her body has still not been recovered. News 8's Tama Ponton has more for us.
Police say that 30-year-old Buddy Robinson and 22-year-old Christiana Fesmeyer knew each other very well. In fact, the two lived in the same two-story apartment building on Highland Avenue in Lewiston, and that is where police say the murder took place. Now, Robinson did not enter a plea when he made his initial court appearance last month. Deputy Attorney General William Stokes would not discuss details of the police investigation at that time, but court documents obtained by News 8 state that Robinson was not fond of Fesmeyer, and the two got into an argument the morning of July 1st. Court documents revealed that Robinson hit Fesmeyer's head against a bathtub and then submerged her in the tub. The documents also say that Robinson's sister, Brandy, who also lived in the apartment building, later told police that her brother disposed of Fesmeyer's body in a swampy area. Deputy Attorney General Stokes says despite not having the body, he is confident he has enough evidence to go to trial. Now, Buddy Robinson is due in court here later this morning at 8:30, and we will continue to keep you updated on what happens on our website, WMTW.com, and later today on News 8. For now, from Auburn, I'm Tama Ponton, News 8 Now.
A New Hampshire man accused of recording video up women's skirts expected to enter a plea in York County court today. 18-year-old Kyle Melhorn was arrested in July at York's Wild Kingdom. Police say he admitted to taking the videos at the park while he pretended to tie his shoes. They also say they found more evidence of similar crimes after searching his phone. Melhorn is charged with disorderly conduct and invasion of privacy.
Well, after a day of counting ballots by hand, former state senator Michael Brennan will be Portland's next mayor. Brennan beat out 14 contenders and a write-in candidate to become the city's first elected mayor in 88 years. With the city's new ranked choice voting system, election officials had to scan each and every ballot and then verify them on a computer. That took 15 rounds of elimination before the city clerk determined that Brennan had the majority votes it needed to win this election.
With Veterans Day tomorrow, many schools are doing their part to educate students about those who served our country. It was Take a Veteran to School Day across the state yesterday. This ceremony was at Memorial Middle School in South Portland. And the purpose is to teach children about the bravery and the sacrifice of our nation's veterans. It's all part of a national effort created by the History Channel, which I think is a great program.
Absolutely. And thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. Have a great day, everyone.